Have you started RE8? I don't think we mentioned that. I don't think I asked that.
I was going to do that right now, but, you know, podcast.
Right, podcast. No, that's all right. I played more Returnal.
Ooh.
That game is 100% my game of the year.
Oh, yes. Well, out of what?
Granted, I've only played like two 2021 games. But, like, it's hard to explain because the game is really well made.
Wait, what's the other game?
Strikers.
All right.
Strikers.
I forgot about Strikers.
Yeah, I think everyone did.
I'm sorry, Strikers. I'll play you again. And I promise you're really good.
I'll eventually play it again. But yeah, Returnal is very good.
Yeah.
Its music is good. The sound design, dude. The way they use the adaptive triggers is so good. Like, so.
PS5, baby.
Well, the game has, like, the guns have an alternative fire. So how it works is if you completely pull down the trigger, you do your alternative fire. If you press it up to a certain point where the controller lets you feel where the point is, so you never get confused. That's your aim down sights.
Yeah.
So you're never confused as to when you're aiming down sights and when you're alternative firing. And then when you pull down the trigger to fire, it's like it rumbles a bit. It feels like you're pressing a gun. But it doesn't lock up. Like, and apparently in RE8 on PS5, it locks up when you try to pull the trigger. You have to, like, really press down on it. Yeah. It's a great game. Great game. Very addictive.
What did you give it so far?
Right now, it's a 9.
A 9?
Yeah. My only issues right now are the weapon variety, upgrades. It's a rogue. Rogue-like game.
Yeah.
So, you go through, like, different floors, and you get upgrades, you get new weapons. But the upgrades are really boring. Like, here's extra HP. Here's some boost to your weapon damage. Here's a better weapon, but it's still, like, the same weapon. It's just better. The upgrades are very boring. Difficulty is questionable. I think I mentioned to you that the game's enemy scaling and enemy difficulty in AI is genuinely unfair at points.
Not like Doom Eternal.
No. Not even.
Doom Eternal is fair because you can actually like just wipe them.
Whenever an enemy hits you, it's entirely your fault.
Yeah, but you also have a giant BFG gun that can just kill most of them.
Returnal doesn't have that. So when you die from something, it sometimes feels like there was just nothing you could do that in that situation but die because the enemy pathing is really weird. Like, there's moves that enemies telegraph that just insta-hit you regardless of where you are. Like, if you're at a certain distance from the enemy that's doing an attack, because most enemies have ranged attacks, but some have, like, we're going to get right in front of you and hit you. And some of them, if you're just not far away enough, you're going to get hit. And you're going to hit for a lot of health. And it's not fun in some cases. And the boss fights. I haven't gotten past the first boss fight. I'm still on my first run of the game, but it's got Kingdom Hearts boss fights.
Oh, no.
And what do you think I mean by that, just out of curiosity?
You said Kingdom Hearts boss fights?
Yeah. What do you think I mean by that?
Unbalanced?
No.
I just thought of Sephiroth.
I mean, the first boss fight in the game has 4 health bars. 4 health bars that are very long, and they take longer to deplete after each bar. So, like, the first
this
bar
is a Dark Souls
pretty,
boss.
Pretty
That's
easy to get through. Second one takes a little bit longer. The third one you better have a full auto weapon. Otherwise, bro, you
are... This is just a...
Yeah, it's...
It's just a Dark Souls boss.
Funny enough, it actually has a mechanic like the Fallen Allies, where you can see where another player died. But in Eternal, you can scan their body, and you can either cleanse it by using some of your in-game ether to, like, just clean it, and I think you get, like, rewards for it. I've never done it. Or you can fight what they fought.
Oh.
Which is usually, like, some special enemy that's, like, super hard, but you get super good rewards out of it. Hmm. And you could do this, like, early on in the run. So you could start a run with some really good stuff and then go fight the boss. The game gives you the ability to do so as soon as you do it. As soon as you unlock the boss room, yeah, you don't have to unlock it again. You just go back to it.
So, do you have any clue what the game is about? Because I've probably done.
Story-wise?
Yeah.
Not much. The game is very vague at this point. It's doing a lot of hinting.
Oh.
I've heard nothing but good things about the story. I've heard it's very well told. But I'm still early on it. I'm still in the first floor. So, there's three floors in a run. And apparently when you beat a run, you unlock three more floors. But it doesn't make you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As soon as you beat 1, 2, 3, you just start at 4. So if you go 1, 2, 3, and then start the second run at 4, when you die in that run, it doesn't take you back to 1, it takes you to 4. So you don't have to redo 1, 2, 3.
So how many are they in total?
I think there's like a couple. You do one run, you get the ending of the game. And then you can do more runs of the game to get, like, more information and really unpack the ending and get more information.
True ending. More.
Yeah, I get, like, a true ending and a full explanation. I don't know. It's not... It's $70.
Yeah.
It's full price game. And it did not need to be. And apparently the developers didn't know that the game was going to be $70. Sony never told them. How do you not know? Right?
How do you not know this?
All they know is that Sony was very proud, very happy with the work that they were doing on the game. And then when the game came out, the studio found out Sony charged $70 for it. So they didn't even know, which I think is really stupid, but it's funny. Because, like, how do you not know?
How do you not know?
But if you have a PS5, I'd say the game is, like, worth, like, 30.
Right.
30 to 30.
I'll probably get it when it's on sale.
Yeah, when it's on sale. It's a PS5 only game.
Like,
at the moment.
Like, I do mean, probably, like, by the time I get a PS5, it will be on sale for
it's
sure.
It's definitely a game you should pick up. It's a great showcase for the console and what it can do. I will say this.
I mean,
this game has old school saves, as in the game doesn't actually save.
Oh.
It saves all permanent progression to the system data. There is no save slots. game saves everything manually to the system. But because it's a roguelike game, not everything is permanent. So it saves what's permanent into the storage of the system, and then everything else is just into the void. Like, if you were in the middle of a run and then you close the game, if you open it back up again, you're just gonna restart your whole run.
Oh.
Yeah, it's weird, which is why these things make it like a 9. As opposed to a full-on 10 out of 10. But it's a definite recommend. Hard recommend. Yeah.
Interesting.